How safe are your Dropbox files from prying eyes? Is your iPhone tracking you? And is the New York Times making money off Twitter? You can find all that out and more on NSFW.
Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for NSFW is brought to you by CashFly at CacheFly.com.
This is NSFW for Wednesday, April 20th, 2011. This episode of NSFW is brought to you by Netflix. Watch thousands of DVD episodes and movies streamed to your PC, Mac, or TV instantly. Plus, get DVDs by mail in about one business day. For your free 30-day trial, go to netflix.com/twit. And by squarespace.com. The fast and easy way to publish a high-quality website or blog. For a free 14-day trial, go to squarespace.com/NSFW. And to make sure you check out their annual plans for savings of up to 20% off.
Explain to Korey how awesome he was, Justin.
Korey, here's the deal. We had a very, like, basically when Brian told me you were coming on the show, we've been trying to figure out, like, how to do, because I think we play a lot of games and stuff like everything, but they always kind of get, like, way too complicated, and we write, like, rules on rules, and, like, the comedy bits sort of, like, fold into each other. So we've been trying to do a little bit more, like, talky bits, and we knew that if you were coming on, there was not going to be any problem with us talking about anything. And then, I don't know at what point we came up with the idea today of doing, like, oh my god, what if we just did everything that Tech News Today did? We just did, like, a parody episode. Not a parody episode that we were making fun of them, but we just...
episode. Like we sung... We basically... It wasn't even, like, a tribute episode. It's like we karaoke'd Tech News Today, which means that it wasn't necessarily good, but it was entertaining to watch because you know these guys.
Well, it's like when a punk band covers Frank Sinatra. It's like, it's the same song, but it's not the same song.
Yes, exactly.
It was a cover.
Yeah, exactly. So we did that, and you were perfect. I mean, I couldn't imagine the show.
Hello, my name is Brian Brushwood, and if you don't know, today is an auspicious day. It's the fourth month and the 20th day, so it's abbreviated 420. And a bunch of people were asking if we were going to do something surreal or bizarre to mess with the minds of people who might have been using an illicit substance today. And the answer is absolutely not. We're going to. Is there a reason you just coughed during that? That was a.
Yeah, because I'm choking offside over here.
That's right. The answer is we are going to do the exact same show that we've always done. So I don't know about you, Justin, but I'm ready to get this thing started. Here we go.
This is NSFW for Wednesday, April 20th, 2011. Welcome to NSFW. I'm Justin Robert Young.
I'm Brian Brushwood.
And I'm Korey Coleman, jamming out to these awesome tunes.
This is the show where we take the day's worth of tech news and kick it around and try and have it make sense for you. Brian, how you doing?
I'm doing really well. We're excited to have back in studio, of course, Korey Coleman, longtime friend of the show, rocking out to NSFW. I don't know about you, but I am ready to put all these shenanigans behind us. I'm ready to talk tech, and let's learn about today's news stories. Justin.
Brian, there is a big thing that blew up on O'Reilly today. Apparently, if you have an iPad or an iPhone, it has been saving all of your location data. It's an unencrypted file that can be taken out by anybody who has knowledge of your root access for your phone, and it's pretty comprehensive. You can pull out the data and pinpoint on a map exactly where you've been over the last couple days.
And in fact, there's an actual program on iOS and on Mac computers that'll actually take all of that unencrypted information, which people didn't feel like they were authorized or notified about, and just it's there for anyone who grabs your phone now knows anywhere you've been. But my thing is,
how much are you grabbing people's phones though?
Bro? Well, I don't know.
How many times is anybody grabbing anybody's phone?
You know what? I like this. I like that they do this. They can see how many hoes I have in different area codes.
Finally!
one of you know what I
did. Definitive proof. It's been a theory for years, a popular theory about Corey's hose in different areas.
So, and in fact, what's funny is they're like, we're on the hunt for Corey Coleman. He's escaped. He's out on the road. We have his cell phone, and we've recovered. These are his bitches.
Yes.
It appears as proof. Though he's running to the northeast as fast as he can, having sex with as many women as he possibly can.
Might be in your house right now. You don't know.
By the way, I like to imagine that map's laid out and, like, you know, like Billy Bob Thornton is looking over it. As you can see, he's making a clear pattern to the northeast. Nearly two hoes a day for the last 3 months.
They're like, well, how much of an area can he cover having sex with women? It's the size of Texas, Mr. President.
As I like to say, a lot.
That's do you ever worry about your phone being stolen, or do you care? You probably don't care.
No, although apparently I worry about my girlfriend's phone being stolen if Corey's around.
What's your girlfriend's name?
I wouldn't do like to know, sir.
Oh, I remember her. She was this deep red scarlet dot on the map. We were on the road in what appears to be the Pacific Northeast.
What is that, Jersey?
It actually looks like the Rhode Island area, I think. I can't tell. That's what
I can't look at this in any other way than it's a different area.
Just follow the dot that's shaped like an ass. Along the
you go, bobbing his long legs.
Oh, is that it? Oh, do you have different? You're like you need a guide, a legend to see.
I am the legend.
I am legend.
You got a name. Yeah, that's right. That's the only way they finally catch you, and they're like, we understand that you murdered those people, Corey, but if you can name every one of these ladies, then you clearly have respect for them, and you deserve to go free.
Legend of Bag of Vance. I bagged all your
right. Speaking of the Legend of Bagger Vance, that's the kind of book you would pull from your local library, but now you don't have to go there anymore, thanks to a new program that Amazon is launching where you can borrow library books on either your Kindle or a Kindle app, so that includes your iPhone, your iPad, and all the devices that has the app on it. You get it for about a week, but it opens up a whole new library of free content that otherwise you'd have to go to a municipal building for.
All right, now see, that's the thing. So it's like, you know, there's already a way for people to borrow content on the internet. We don't need a new library. This business of you needing a library card is insane. The only thing I remember about libraries is homeless people looking at Playboys. And they warned us about it when we went to go visit a library when I was a kid. Do you ever go to library, Corey?
I didn't go to the library when I was a kid. I'm not going to the library today. What are you talking about? Books?
On purpose? What?
If it ain't moving, I don't want to see it.
Well, they got a lot of other stuff. They got like DVDs and stuff. I know that was where all my super cheap friends used to pick up stuff back in the day.
See, I'm old enough to remember when they didn't have none of them. Like when our libraries just had books.
Did you ever go?
And now you're just furious, like that you refuse to let them evolve, Corey. You're like, no, you had books, and that's all you'll ever have, in my opinion.
What is this? This is not what the library I knew. I mean, what's the deal with libraries now? Anyway, I mean, here's the thing. I mean, like with record stores and other stuff.
With record stores and other suitable examples you can imagine, because I'm not thinking of them.
record stores?
I really couldn't use a library when I was a dinosaur.
If I was at a library, I could have a thesaurus.
I couldn't remember these things. My vocabulary would be so much better. Are people worried about libraries not being around anymore? Do we really have any use for libraries anymore at all? I mean, you mentioned like DVDs and then they have books there, but now we get everything over the internet, whether it be from Netflix, illegally getting it, or having Kindles and iPads that we can read books on. Our library is becoming
the homeless?
I think they were done forever ago. Like Brian said, literally the only demographic for which a library still serves a vital, vital need is homeless people and people who for some reason need to roll their dice to internet pornography somewhere other than where they would otherwise.
So they're turning into crack houses.
That's right. Libraries are the new crack houses. You heard it here first. On
they're
NSFW.
Shooting galleries.
You want to know what the relevance of a library is? Smoke your crack there. And take a piss in the corner.
So, maybe we're at a very influential crossroads for libraries. As the books and the content move on to our mobile phones, for which we can enjoy at our leisure, now you can use that physical structure for something that everyone's always wanted to, burning yourself with a hot crack lighter as you fall asleep from your haze.
They are becoming roach motels for homeless people and pedophiles. Because that's where pedophiles would go. You know what I'm talking about.
What are they gonna do? They're like cutting and pasting like various magazines and like children's stories. Or I mean, what is this way? Why pedophiles?
Because then we go to the children's section.
Okay,
and look at kids.
Okay, all right.
What they would do is look at that kid reading a book, but they stand behind a shelf and pull that one book out so they can see through it through the. Yes, keep reading. Yes.
By the way, I like to imagine that they have, it's like it's all regimented there for them. So yeah. They just have like the same bookshelf like behind where the kids section is. It's like the footsteps, like the sticker footsteps. And they walk there and you have the one same book. It's Narnia that they pull out every time. Like,
maybe actually in my mind, he's like reading The Merchant of Venice, but there's like eye holes cut out. He's holding up over.
Like those haunted house shows where they have a painting on the wall and the building would be looking through two peepholes in it. So the painting would look at people as they pass by.
Yes, apparently that's exactly what we're saying.
Yeah, I don't even know. You don't even know what I'm talking about. You're like, apparently you haven't watched enough Scooby-Doo.
Apparently not.
Yeah. Exactly. And speaking of pretty pictures, that's what AT&T was looking at today as they announced a 39% year-on-year profit with their earnings report. Apparently the Verizon iPhone had no effect on them, and it was a big boom for AT&T when a lot of people predicted that they'd be bleeding because of the iPhone on the better network that is Verizon.
Damn.
So okay, this is one of those things where everybody, and I don't want to, you know, toot my own horn, but I called this. I called it live and in public. I said everybody says they're gonna jump ship. Nobody's gonna jump ship because it's a pain in the butt and there's no definite tangible way to advance. And so that is the important thing.
Well, here's the other thing about
Brian hates his friends.
Well, you know, the other thing about the Verizon iPhone, I mean, people like me who want to jump ship, we're looking at the limitations of the Verizon iPhone, which one of them being, and I'm sure you know this, is that you could not surf the net or do anything else on the internet or check your email or anything at the same time as being on a call.
All right, what's the worst thing you've ever searched for while you're on the on a phone call with someone else? And don't say the obvious. I want something interesting.
It's not what I was searching for, it's what I was doing. I wasn't looking for porn. I was putting porn out there. I was taking pictures of my groin.
You know? You were not downloading. You were
yeah,
uploading.
I was like, yes, keep talking. I hear you. Yes.
By the way,
I'm not going to show the video.
Oh, why don't you show that, man?
No, I will not show that.
And I have my pants on. Here, I'll send you a picture. How about
okay,
that?
Okay. All right, and we're good.
Hey, come on, come on. I got some entertainment for the people.
It's using the internet, so you need to be uploading it.
Wait, did you just? Are you doing a ham bone?
It's my junk man.
Oh, you're. You know, it's funny.
She won't let me show my penis.
I'm pretty sure you said junk band, but I heard junk band.
If I can't show my junk, I'll do my junk band rendition.
Okay, all right.
Could I be the new tune?
Wait, what does that have to do with the internet?
Everything.
Is that like the popular thing that you need to upload your hillbilly slack?
It's the friendly version of showing junk. He wants to let me show my real junk, so I'm going to just show junk band. Can I see your new intro?
It's funny because that's exactly the face you make as you upload the picture.
I will absolutely guarantee you that before this is over, there will be a tour poster of Korey Coleman and his junk band.
Korey Coleman's junk band Christmas.
Exactly. Which, by the way, that's the last face any of those girls saw in that map of the North.
Yeah, they saw this. Put it back on me. I was like...
Before you die, you see the junk.
All right, before your ultimate pleasure, this is the last thing you will see.
You wake up in a hamper and Corey is 20 miles away at the next dot.
Oh, my God. All right. Well,
but check your phone. Exactly. I left something for you.
And by the way, checking your phone is something that you are going to do when you have Netflix, Brian. They're sponsoring this show in their iPhone app as well as their iPad app. And every app they have on pretty much every possible platform is fantastic. I absolutely love it. I've been out on the road a lot lately and watching the Larry Sanders Show on my phone before I go to sleep and when I wake up is, you know, perfect. And Netflix is the best thing ever. What you guys need to do is go to netflix.com/twit. It's not show specific. It's just for the network at large, and get on that now. If you don't already have it, but I mean, so many people have it. It's like the most popular thing ever, right, Brian?
Oh my gosh. Look, it is not only the most popular thing ever. It's the greatest thing ever. And in fact, do you know what the first thing Korey Coleman said when he showed up into the studio was? He said, who are the sponsors? Because, and the moment I said Netflix, there's this big old, his eyes got bright, he got all excited. How long have you been doing the Netflix thing?
I've been doing Netflix for 15 years now. I had it before it was even out. Let me tell you something. I want to thank Netflix for keeping people like me out of the library. You know? Don't have to go now. You know, about 2 years ago, I said, you know what? I think I'm going to go to the library. I haven't been a long time. And then, boom, Netflix showed up. I'm like, I ain't got to go.
Yeah, they got movies at the library. Yeah. But who knows?
If you would have went to that library where everybody was smoking all that crack, maybe you would have got hooked.
I said, I'm tired of smelling like crack and piss when I come out the library. You know, Netflix is keeping me, the slogan should be Netflix, keeping you from smelling like crack and piss.
Okay, that's.
Okay, no, you know what? Seriously, let me say something about Netflix, because I do love Netflix. Okay. This is serious. Brian's already like, man, you already screwed this show.
No,
we lose another sponsor because let me tell you something. Last night,
yes,
I was on Netflix.
Yes,
I've been acting ignorant, but I'm gonna drop some knowledge on you real quick. I'm gonna get some.
All right, everybody, bring it down.
There's a Russian animator that I love. I'm not gonna even try and say his name right now because I just got through drinking cider. But he has made some of my favorite short animated films, and animated from about 1939. He has made a compilation of films called The Cameraman's Revenge. A lot of people haven't heard of this. It's kind of an underground thing. And I just typed it in last night to see, I wonder if Netflix has this. I'm just going to put in something random. Guess what? They had it!
And that's the thing. Their library, the back catalog of all the instant streaming stuff is just getting bigger and bigger. And in fact, one of the things that I like to do is to just see what random stuff comes up when I type in random things. So I say we start a new game here, where we pick a movie based on a random search term. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to, let's see, we got here, there's my login. I'm going to type in here, Corey's Junk. And we'll see what comes up.
And if it's,
okay, we got the movie Junk, and we've got...
That's me.
Juno.
The true story. By the way, how do you think that happened?
Yeah, Michael. See, they had it. They had it up there. It's crazy.
They never showed what color that baby was.
Juno was just one of the dots on that line as he made this way.
That's the last thing I said to her. She said, whose baby is this? I said, Juno. Hey, you know what? One thing I can say about Netflix, and this is serious,
yes,
a lot of people are... One of the criticisms they have right now is that, well, a lot of the new releases are still taking a little bit of time to appear on Netflix. I will say give it time because they are very much working towards that. They would not be shifting their business model to just people leaving DVDs and going to subscription service.
They do have the DVDs because they have all the shipping centers. They do mail everything by physical DVDs, and the new releases are available. As soon as they're available for the rental market, they show up as a DVD.
But they're shifting their business model towards streaming.
Yes, which is even better.
I don't even think that they would do this as confidently as they're doing it if they weren't at least planning on having new releases available sooner.
I'll tell you what's up. Toy Story 3. Toy Story 3 is available right now. We watched Karate Kid.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that was on last summer. In fact, most of the best movies that were on our Summer Draft League from last year are available right now. Right, Justin?
Absolutely. I'll say this. I mean, Netflix is now what HBO and pay cable was like 10 years ago, where now it is like social coup. When something comes on Netflix, like I've seen, they announced Mad Men's coming on, and you have a whole bunch of people who are like, they really kind of, they've heard people talk about Mad Men, they want to watch it, and now they're like excited. And like, oh, I got to catch up with Mad Men. It's going to be super awesome. If you're not on it, not only are you missing out on all the awesome content, you're missing out on what all your friends are
doing.
But
here's the point that I was going to make with all the new stuff that they're talking about. Don't worry so much about the new stuff. You don't understand. I see so many new things right now as far as the first releases that come to the theater, you know, whatever. I love catching up on movies that I have not seen that I've been wanting to see in the past.
Yep.
A lot of classic films. Last night I was watching, I don't even know where this came from, some guy who just made a compilation of, albeit crappy, but experimental short films. Yep. And it was just fun to watch that. I mean, you find so much variety on Netflix if you're not out there looking for the new releases.
There's a little bit of the Netflix roulette effect where, like, that's how I yes. saw Man on Wire. I'm like, well, I guess this is what I'm watching now. I'll watch the first 5 minutes, and then I get sucked into the entire thing.
Those are all fantastic. Yeah, no, Netflix.com/twit. Again, it's not /NSFW, it is /twit. Go support the network and enjoy it. It's going to be really awesome. And Brian, Korey, those are fantastic recommendations. And recommendations are what News.me is counting on. The iPad news aggregator is blessed by big publishers as a way for you to get news based on your Twitter and Facebook feeds. It looks through there and looks through Bitly on what the most popularly retweeted articles are to find for you a recommendation list of news stories for today that you can enjoy. But it also is a subscription process. It costs around $30 for the year or 99 cents for the week. Brian, are these kind of pay models ever going to succeed?
I don't know. This sounds like a ripoff of... I mean, it's like I got my Flipbook. I got my Twitter. I don't know. Do you use Twitter?
Me? Oh, yes. Yeah. I use it all the time.
What do you use it for?
To check on my babies. That's how I open up. Every time I get on Twitter, I open up with the line, how my babies do. And then... I get a lot of responses. Hey, you got to understand, Brian. Of course, it's
a lot
Twitter.
Of dots. Hey,
man, I'm telling you.
I actually don't. I thought I followed you, but you're saying, but I never see.
I don't do it all that often. I mean, we have two kind of Twitter things going on. My own personal one, and we have one going on for the site that I work for.
Yeah.
Now, being somebody who makes a living by internet, I use Twitter. I mean, you have to kind of use Twitter for, especially when you're involved in something as heavily as social networking involved as the site that I work for.
Okay, which one should I be following? I'm going to go to twitter.com/what? Korey Coleman?
Look up Korey Coleman. Yeah, I don't think you follow him, man.
If I don't, I'm a terrible... Wait a minute, Korey Coleman? Sorry, bro, that page doesn't exist. Is it Kate Coleman?
Try Kay Coolman.
Yes. You don't even know. That's a bad sign. When you don't even know your own. You're like, listen, all the babies know my name. That's
exactly.
All that matters.
That's all that matters. They know who I am.
There you are.
There I am. Look, you found it. See?
Yeah, you have a tweet.
And you're not following him. What a great friend you are.
I'm not loaded in. I'm not logged in is all. Yeah, all right. Well, I do follow
so
you.
Why can't you just hit follow then?
Well, I can't. There's. Oh, well, here. It'll say you have to sign in to do that.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. But if you'll notice, that's why I don't see it. Is all a bunch of this is a whole bunch of at replies. See, I'm good about the at replies too. Not so much the posting. Are you checking your Twitter account on the show?
Let me tell you something. They always try to get you. Everybody with an agenda. I'm trying to do business with a friend so he can like cater an event that I'm going to have pretty soon. Yesterday I said, I want to talk some business with you. He's like, okay, I'm going to call you back. Don't call me back. But today he emails me and said, you want to go to church this Sunday?
And what did you say? You said, I don't know. This is the pastor high.
How many hot milfs are in your church? How many hoes and area codes can I get at your church?
Okay.
I'm sorry.
If we were to draw a sphere around your church, how many hoes /area codes would it encompass?
Boy, I love Netflix, man. I tell you, Netflix is a wonderful service.
What was
everything
the point
you
of
want.
The story? What are you talking there? About the church and the catering? Yeah.
By the way, it's true. I apparently did not follow Korey, but I do now.
I heard that they had this Harry Potter movie that's coming out this summer. Let me tell you about it. It's supposed to be the last one. Netflix said they got one more after that.
What?
Yeah.
What? Netflix, did you, what?
Breaking you didn't hear news. About this?
Breaking? I'm sorry.
Special report.
This just in, we have important news live from NSFW correspondent. We go now in the field to Korey Coleman. Korey, what do you have for us, sir?
I'm a liar. I didn't know you were going to give me that big of an intro on that. Hey, I'm at the crossroads now. Should I keep going?
No,
I'm pinning myself in a corner with this one.
You are, in fact, a liar. And so is Sony and anybody else who said that the PSP Go would go any farther. They officially shuttered the platform today, saying that they would provide service for it. But as far as inventory goes, it is finito.
The PSP Go. My guess is Korey not only has never seen a PSP Go, but doesn't even know what one is.
Yes, I do.
Okay, what is it?
What are you talking about? It's a PSP that goes. Where it goes, I don't know.
Somebody duct taped a PSP.
Is that okay? Now, from what I understand, that Sony is releasing two new types of mobile devices. They have the phone, and then they have the mobile gaming device, sort of a new PSP.
Justin?
Sure.
What the hell? I mean,
I totally thought you were going to hit the soundboard, like response for that or something.
I don't like the way you asked me. Hey, Justin, is this stupid son of a bitch real?
You know what? We're just this just in.
Special report.
Korey is stupid.
No, Korey's apparently.
I'm pretty sure you're right. I didn't know whether Brian wanted me to do something, but I do believe. Yeah, they have some new ones coming out. But I mean, I never use these. Like, I just to me, the best thing that you could possibly do is play games on the iPhone. I can't imagine bringing a more robust kind of platform out there, just because I don't know. It's like, I don't want to be immersed. It's all about 2 seconds of a game.
It's all about timing. If there had been a smartphone that was awesome for games, and they tried to do that with the Engage, the Nokia thing a while ago. But if you had the right product at the right time, you could have tapped into the hardcore gamer market. But the casual gamer market is so much bigger. That's why the iPhone is the winner now.
Yep.
Speaking of winners, the FBI would be the winner if they ask Dropbox for your information, because Dropbox announced today, as part of their new terms of service, that they will hand over to the authorities anything that they ask for. Basically, it is encrypted, but they will de-encrypt and hand over the information if the FBI or CIA or any kind of other body asks for it. Brian, does this make you nervous about uploading stuff to Dropbox?
I don't know. Dropbox, I never got it. That was like everyone was always sending me links. They're like, get on my Dropbox. I was like, that's confusing. I don't understand.
Yeah.
Corey, what kind of stuff would you upload to Dropbox that you wouldn't want the government seeing?
I would want them to see a lot of things. Like, I want to upload these nuts so that they can. Now, what are you talking about, Brian? I'm talking about, planners. you're so uneasy, man. They can have that. You know, the government. I don't know what's wrong, man.
Nothing's wrong. Everything's fine here, officer. Everything's good.
So you bought them? You bought the planners?
Yeah. Like, why I'm gonna upload yours? Them. No, you listen. I put nothing on Dropbox that I don't want anybody to see. A lot of private things I don't put up there. I don't like to put all that kind of information out
there. Are you paranoid that anything that goes online, everything's going to be out there?
There's always a possibility.
What's the most embarrassing thing you've had go out there?
I'm sure there's a sex tape floating around somewhere, but it's not on the internet. But somebody could easily put it on there. You know? Oh my God.
Well, no, I'm just trying to figure out.
No, you want to know? Here's my okay. The thing I'm most nervous about, as any other person is out there, is my bank account. My bank account is used for a lot of things: PayPal, certain credit cards,
ladies.
And some of those too. Yeah. And so I'm nervous about that. I mean, they had that. What happened recently where some information was taken from a lot of businesses out there, Capital One being one of them?
Yeah, I'm not worried about any of that. I don't know. Seems like it sucks to have your identity stolen, but you're not on the hook for anything.
Well, all I'm saying is there are hackers out there who are always looking for a way to get that private information, you know, a roster, a catalog, a file, several files of private information. And they're constantly working on that. So, I mean, listen, it to me, it's a matter of, and maybe we'll be lucky enough not to be caught up in this. It's just not a matter of if this will happen. It's a matter of when this is going to happen.
So I just realized that on the record, I said, it's not a big deal. I've heard identity stolen. I don't want to give anyone ideas at all.
Brian does. He wants to give you the idea that it's totally cool to go thieve somebody else's identity. So go ahead and start with Brian.
Hold
back on. Scares you. In fact, he puts a $500
This just in, we are getting reports from Twitter that none other than our very own Kate Coolman has been followed by our good friend of the show, Michael Rooker.
Michael Rooker, that's right. I was about to say he follows you.
Did you know? How did you know? Why does he follow you?
Because I remember.
Why is he following me? Hey, look, put the camera on me. Why would he not want to follow this?
I'm just saying.
Hey, look, he's fine. You want to follow me? Because of this.
Exchange.
He loves my junk.
On junk fan.
Band. Yeah, he's a junk band fan.
Junk band. He's a junk band aficionado. Listen,
he's a junk band fan.
He's a junk band fan. That's right. And he loves this junk right here. Why are you getting jealous, man? All of a sudden, he's like, what's he following you for?
No, what I'm saying, I know the only reason he follows us is because he appeared on the show, and we lucked out into tricking him into thinking.
He did an interview with Korey. You didn't listen
to it.
He did.
I didn't listen.
I'll call you.
Special report.
Special report. Korey is not as good of a friend with Brian as he thought he was.
That you feel right now is certainly not felt in Cupertino. Apple announced that their quarterly earnings beat analyst expectations, making $6.40 a share when the expectations were only $5.36. Peter Oppenheimer from Apple said that they have sold every iPad 2 they could possibly make since they launched it.
I'm sorry, just repeat just the first line again. Just give me the first line again.
Apple beats expectations?
That's not what it said. Yeah, like read the whole first line.
Quarterly earnings report time.
Yeah, like read the whole, there was a word you said somewhere. You read the whole thing again. Do it again. Read it exactly the same.
Quarterly earnings report time. Apple beat analyst expectations.
That's not what you said. You totally said. Chat room, what? I'm going to kick it over to the chat room. Chat room, what did Justin Robert Young say? Give the word. You definitely said analyst. Is what you said. They all noticed.
Okay. Well, they beat the analyst too.
Special report. Justin loves anals.
Oh my God. Hey, well, Apple apparently beat it, whatever it is. I don't know how comprehensive of a list it was, but they beat the hell out of it.
Do you have an iPad?
460 or 640 to 3 or 536.
Can I ask you something? Do you have an iPad? Both you guys.
I have
an iPad. You got two.
I got two. I got the first generation one for me. And then the second generation one, that's the one that came with FaceTime.
Wow, look at you.
So I wanted to give it to the kids.
You have threesomes with your iPads. I've got two of them.
Oh, Bonnie.
I'm the Charlie Sheen of iPads.
Bring it. I called them my goddesses.
Yeah, my goddesses. The iPad exactly. One and the iPad 2.
And you leave one to play with your kids, too. You know, you
okay, let me tell you why I don't have one. Okay, I think that, everybody who has an iPad aren't an iPad 2 that I know, they love them. But for me, I am in that very small category of graphic artists who say that I want, and I know Steve Jobs does not want to have a stylus. Ever since the Newton didn't do that well, he's like, no more stylus, everything doing them, just Minority Report type stuff. But I want a stylus because I want the feeling of having a portable sketch pad. And I want the thing like I have on my Wacom tablet, something that comes to a point that has pressure sensitivity and can allow me to get the feeling of sketching like I do on paper. Only then when I get an iPad. Other than that, I think that I'm an Apple fan. I have, every computer that I've had for the last 3 years has been a Mac. I use several of their products.
Now, wait a minute. Actually, chat room is saying that Wacom is going to make a stylus that will come out for the iPad. Like you'll be able to use a stylus on an iPad.
You ask these liars when. I've been waiting for a long time.
That's Corey.
I don't believe
this. Aggressive with the chat room.
I know. Don't toy with me on this.
Give me a time when this will happen.
I've been waiting too long.
Corey, you want the good news or the bad news?
Well, I think the bad news is what, like 2015 or something is coming out?
No.
What's the good news? Okay, tell me.
Well, the good news is that somebody has actually made Corey Coleman and the Junk Band making love across the USA tour photos.
That is not me.
I know. That's the bad news, is that this person didn't realize that there's another black person.
There's a black person.
On
why don't you just get Gary Coleman and put it up there?
He is Leon.
Can't tell the difference.
I like that. There's some good news and some bad news. nothing to do with the iPad.
I'm sorry. You were saying...
I'll tell you what. I mean, they would be very, that character is very slimming on Leon. So.
It is. Hey, Leon got a lot of ass on him. I'll tell you that much. And it's all up here in this front. But you know what? I think I love Apple, love their products, love Steve Jobs, but I think with the iPad, they have convinced a lot of people to buy a product that they absolutely don't need.
fact that they need it.
Like, but then again, do I need a PS3? No, but I got one. So what? Who?
I'll tell you what. I went through a couple airports over the last couple days, yes. And I saw way more iPads than I saw laptops. I think that's what people who bought laptops that they didn't really need 90% of what a laptop can do. Buy iPads.
And I hate that kind of talk because I need.
You're not going to believe this. If you seriously need it and this is a real thing you need, I got good news for you.
Special. Oh, my God. Ooh. Look
from
out there.
Our West Coast field agents, we have that Wacom is announcing a bamboo stylus for the iPad posted today.
Oh my God! When is this coming out? Oh my God!
According to this, it says here, Wacom announces bamboo stylus for iPad. Looking for an iPad stylus as of Wednesday, you have yet another option to consider: the bamboo stylus for iPad, created by the fine folks at Wacom. It's important to note that blah 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 will be available in mid-May for $30 from most major retail outlets.
Oh my God! I will forever remember this day.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to please capture the enraptured look on Corey's face.
I know.
Because that is going to be the look that you will have on your face when you sign up for Squarespace.com. Yes, folks.
Squarespace?
Nice segue, yes. Justin. I love that.
Oh, absolutely. Look, hey, don't ever point out the segues, all right? A segue pointed out is one that I forget how the rest of the old saying goes.
What? I was giving him a compliment. How dare, man?
I'm making a joke for people who aren't in the room. You don't understand, but they'll appreciate it.
Making me feel bad.
Justin?
Squarespace.com is the web publishing platform that allows you to create fantastic sites that, Brian, they will never go down. Like an enraged, crack-smoking rhino barreling through the center of town, being shot by tranquilizer dart after tranquilizer dart. It will not stop until your website is out to everybody who wants to see it.
All right, here's the thing about Squarespace. A lot of people think it's hard to make a website, that you have to even know what HTML stands for. Fact is, you don't have to know any of that stuff. Mm. You can have a badass-looking website up in 36. Do you know what we should do? We should team up with our friends over at the URDB and have one of our fine members here in the chat realm actually set a world record for fastest published website from inception to idea. So you start the video, you turn, you go to Squarespace, you say the words, I just had an idea for, Banana Man 8000, the website.
Exactly. So, or squarespace.com/Corey's junk face.
There we go.
Junk face,
right? And so you grab a picture and then you go to squarespace.com/NSFW. Now that's the important thing. If you want to get this world record, you can have the fastest idea to execution published website by going to squarespace.com/NSFW. And then what happens? Do you have to put in a credit card there, Justin?
Absolutely not. You can take your credit card and cut it in half. Now, you will need it after the free two-week trial is done, so you may not want to do that. But you could just to get on the website because it requires no credit card information. Just sign up and go. So, by the way, if you are reading or listening to this, rather, after we record live, you'll be able to go to squarespace.com/Corey's junk face and see the website that will no doubt be
Corey's junk face.squarespace.com, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Come on.
And, but here's the important thing. You have a professional-looking website.
No junk face. Come on. No.
Oh, I'm sorry. We got to give. There we go. Wait, move the microphone so they can put this on. Corey's junk face. There we go. That'll be the image at Corey's junk face.
You gotta look like the creatures from I Am Legend when you do that.
Oh my Jesus! Look, you know what? You mentioned me on Twitter, and I just got like 50 Twitter invites now.
That's awesome. That's good. That's why you've been so distracted. Yeah. Okay, so I'm sure somebody captured that. Head on over to squarespace.com/NSFW, and we're running out of time here, Justin. We got a lot of stories. We need to tell a lot of news stories in a very short amount of time, like rapid-fire style. Do we have a segment for that?
Brian, we can just do whatever we always do on the show, which is the Fuse News.
Rapid-fire style.
Reuters is the latest to weigh in on the iPhone 5 speculation. According to three random hobos and a chick who works at Denny's, iPhone 5 production begins in July and ships in September. Also, your lumberjack slam is up.
several online poker sites were shut down last week thanks to the FBI and New York law enforcement officials, which meant getting money out of the site's accounts became difficult. Many players cried and then turned to underground cockfighting.
Facebook, HP, and the OpenStack Project and 74 other organizations have joined the Open Invention Network. The OIN was founded in 2005 by IBM, NEC, Wade Boggs, Novell, Phillips, Lyndon B. Johnson, Red Hat, Garfield's pesky nemesis Nermal, the Legion of Doom, Ghost Rider, the motorcycle riding spirit of vengeance, Ghost Rider, the helpful mystery-solving spirit, Sony, and Aquaman.
Paul Ottolini says Intel's building a version of Honeycomb for its processors. This isn't just something Intel is reverse engineering. Google gave it the Honeycomb source code.
Welcome to the Honeycomb hideout.
It also gave them a bootleg copy of source code starring Jake Gyllenhaal. At first, Intel was like, but isn't this stealing? And then Google's like, what are you, the cops now? And then Intel was like, I guess not. And then they made out.
Google appears to have maps on the brain. The company introduced Google Earth Builder, which is a new service that will let users build map layers on existing Google Maps. They hope by mixing various levers of Google Maps with liquid starch and white glue, they can make a completely bitchin' Google papier-mâché bust of Vin Diesel that if you look at it for long enough, will look like he's saying,
Vin Diesel,
Last week, a vulnerability in Skype for Android could allow sensitive data to be scraped by malicious apps. These malicious apps could then scrape your elbow, causing a nasty gash and quite possibly infection. Officials recommend updating your phone and Bactine.
A Facebook glitch yesterday led some Facebook users to get inundated with emails telling them about every change to their Facebook pages, even if the settings were set otherwise. When pressed for comment, Facebook replied by emailing you that your slut ex-girlfriend is now friends with your quote-unquote best friend, which I'm sure means he's taking her to see prom this Friday. Sure, watch me care. I seriously don't care. Who cares about them? They're both stupid anyway. Good luck listening to her talk about how hilarious the Real Housewives of Orange County is, Tommy. Ugh, you're such a backstabbing hypocrite.
Special report.
Yes! Time for the calendar, Brian. Happy birthday to George Hasato Takai Altman, born April 20th, 1937, better known as George Takei.
Yep, and I tell you what, we also have one email coming in here. It says here, this is a real email. Hey, guys, just listened to the Between the Sheets-style pre-recorded episode, and I thought it was really good. I know at the time reception wasn't that positive, but looking back at it now, I thoroughly enjoyed it. I would not at all be opposed to another episode like this. It was like an after show, but with less YouTube videos. I think you guys should consider doing this style episode every now and then, maybe once every month or two. I'm sure the rest of Chat Realm wouldn't mind as long as it's recorded live. Plus, you guys could go from very little show prep to zero show prep. Just get on and talk. I love the show, Leon. And that's not your friend, Leon.
Okay.
That's a different Leon.
There's more than one Leon.
My nagger friend, Leon.
Yeah, that nagger. He's somebody who's hard to be around. I guess that's it. Have we covered all the tech news of today?
We have covered all of today's tech news, Brian. I want to thank our guest, Corey Coleman. Corey, thank you for coming on.
Y'all kicking me out? That's it?
Kicking you out.
You're asking me politely to leave? Okay. Okay, I got you. That was short.
We're just saying that if people want to watch the rest of the story, they can join us over at justin.tv.
Tot TV, too. Yes. Okay. It's fine for tots. Corey, don't worry. Me and you can hang out at the library afterward. It'll be fun. I got a few friends there.
I have some piss and crack.
Some piss crack.
Yeah, all right.
And, of course, Brian Brushwood. Brian, if you want to tell everybody where they can find out more about you.
I recently have a genuine grown-up Facebook page, and I'm trying to get some good followers. What I mean by that is, like, originally I hit the 5,000 max, and I just stopped promoting Facebook at all, and I didn't do anything with it. And so now I actually want people to come to facebook.com/Schwood. That's S-H-W-O-O-D. Why don't this my name?
I like that. I've always loved that. I like the way you say it. Schwood.
Facebook.com/Schwood. And let's give a reason for me to have a fan page now. Give me a like. You like me, don't you?
Oh, yeah, sure. Like them up. By the way, folks, if you want to hear about news of the weird, you can always go to weirdthings.com. You can download the Weird Things podcast, or you can go find Weird Things TV on YouTube. Please subscribe. Mm-hmm. And tomorrow, I am going to be on The Morning Stream, Scott Johnson's morning
Steve
show.
Johnson. Steve Johnson of The
John
Morning.
John Steveson. John Steveson is a man from Ohio who has the Pants Frog Network, and They have a morning show in which they stream all the morning. And I'm going to be on there talking about News of the Weird. So frogpants.com, check out the morning stream live. Or when it's done tomorrow, go pick it up on iTunes. Follow Justin R. Young on Twitter for all the info.
This was a fun episode, but there's absolutely nothing remarkable or out of the unusual for it. And that's unfortunate, but outside of that, I had a great time. We'll see you next Tuesday on our daily tech talking show, right?
On NSFW Today. See you tomorrow. I had a plan.
Jamming tunes, man. I love them.
You, last time you sang, you made up lyrics for NSFW last time.
I did?
Yeah, no, do it again this time.
Okay, here we go.
All right, here we go. Yeah, go. All
right, Schwood.
Yeah.
Schwood.
What it gives me when he says that word makes me so hot, my pants are kind of dirt. It's nice and warm, just like Schwood's button.
Yes, people, the greatest rapper ever.
Okay. Greatest rapper alive.
That's a
special report.
I do have confirmation right here that that Ace Detective Self believes that this is the highest quality NSFW show he's ever seen. So, congratulations.
Special report.
Being joined on the line right now from our West Coast division, we go to the news desk of one Tomas Moritz. Thomas, are you there, sir?
Hello, Brian.
Okay, so walk me through what happened here.
Well, I've got the I'm working on the legal papers right now for the copyright violations.
What? Yes, it can't be a copyright violation.
It's my fault.
You can't copyright Segways, Tom.
You don't own Segway. You're not the guy who ran off a cliff in a Segway. You're Tom. Yeah,
I think the evidence will be mostly from the news fuse and the analyst.
You mean the completely independently created Fuse News?
Yeah, Fuse News. It's 100% different. Come on, man.
Plus, the mispronunciation of words like analyst
was
disparaging to our show.
Was that intentional, Justin?
No!
Were you riffing on that?
No! Why would I do that? Why would I go straight the entire show and then go, analyst?
I think it was sexy. Myself.
Corey liked it.
I was turned on. I was salivating.
So what do you think that dot line was?
There you go.
Analyst.
Follow the dotted line straight to your anal.
Right to list. Listen, we're on the path of Corey Coleman, a.k.a. the analyst.
The analyst.
That's very soft rhymes like the mentalist.
Yeah,
it's not a list. It's more like the mentalist can read minds. You can read asses.
I can read asses. That's right. Hold on. Talk to me. It says it's lonely. So who are you?
Oh, yeah. You guys don't know each other. First of all, are you familiar with the work of Corey Coleman?
Yes, I am. I follow him on Twitter.
What?
Oh, see, look at that.
Unlike me.
Oh, wow, man. Yeah, because he's a good friend of Corey, although he's never met him.
Not as good of friends as apparently. Oh, what's your name, man?
Tom.
Tom, apparently Tom and I are really good friends.
Apparently you guys
I don't know you anymore, that's Brian. Right,
clearly you don't.
Who are you?
Sir. Basically,
the same Schwood I know.
Tom is the one, and what's funny is this is how stupidly complicated the bit was going to be. Was like we were going to do all this, and then at the end, Justin was like, and then we'll reveal it's an April Fool's prank. And everyone will be surprised because it's not April 1st. And I was like, let's please not make it that complicated. So,
I got to admit, like our April Fools will be 420 because stoners watch us. So, this will be the time to pull a prank.
Tom, when did you catch wind? Because you were obviously watching at some point. That's when I started paying attention to you on the Twitter feed. You started sending in those links.
Yeah, I got a couple of people on Twitter. It's like, you have to watch NSFW. And then Burke emails me and was like, you've got to see the open for NSFW. I'm like, all right, I gotta see what they're up to. And the first thing I run into is the Netflix ad. So I didn't know what was going on. I'm like, they're just talking about Netflix. It's the Netflix ad. You don't know what the big
deal like
is.
It sounds like NSFW. They're being silly, yeah.
And as soon as you came out of that into, I can look at my lineup. And into the news.me. As soon as you segued to news.me, I was like, oh, I know what they're up to.
Well, by the way, Brian and I are on the phone while you guys are getting ready for TNT, and he's like, oh my God, I'm really nervous. They're going to see me in their document copying and pasting.
I did. I actually called, like I knew, because I needed to steal your lineup so that we could, like, our show prep was to watch your show and make up jokes while it was going on. So I went there, and of course, in the Google Docs, you can see who else has it open, and I'm like, I don't want them to be, like, in the text all of a sudden, like, why is Brushwood in our tech news?
So you were, so it was while we were doing the show, you were in the doc.
Well, yes, while you were doing the doing show prep is when I went to steal. I copied and pasted your show notes so that we would be able to start writing our I don't know if it's a parody or a tribute or what this was.
Homage.
Is homage. An homage. a violation of all we've worked for? That's what this was.
Hemorrhage.
Belittling. Hemorrhage.
Hemorrhage.
Says the analyst. See that all?
Yes.
The analyst says
it's
coming a mirage.
This fall to CBS. The analyst.
The ass whisperer.
Oh my God. Stylistic parody. This is like when Weird Al doesn't exactly copy the tune, but you could tell who he's riffing on.
I like to think of it as us stealing TNT show prep and doing the worst possible job.
Now, you realize...
I was kind of disappointed because I immediately looked at the doc and I thought, oh, if they're in there, I'm just going to start changing stuff.
Oh, dude!
But you weren't. You very wisely just copied.
Oh, we copied our own. We stole your jewels and made our own copy.
And by the way, the only reason why we didn't just work off your doc was because we're too stupid to remember the jokes that we wrote for the news fuse.
Yeah,
otherwise,
we actually wrote our own crappy version of the news fuse.
Yeah, I noticed there was a twist.
It's right.
Oh. Tom, sometimes you sound like Christopher Walken. Just sometimes.
Hello.
This watch.
That was actually
Excuse
not.
Excuse me. Was that an ass talking?
carried this watch in my ass.
That's Comrade Carhax, all the way from Sweden. What's going on, Carhax?
Sorry, I missed the first part of the show. I was watching How It's Made.
For those of you who don't, Corey and Tom, the running joke was we had. Can you pull the picture of the Pie High Dog?
I'll do what I can.
I'm sure somebody will have it in there. But
Pie High Dog.
Yeah, dude.
there's a picture that kind of is our one note simulation of people who are high and watch the show, and the voice of that dog was provided by Ryan Connolly, who's like one all-encompassing stoner line was out of that dog's mouth. Y'all ever watch How It's Made?
I got a bunch of Discovery Channel on the DVR. Y'all ever watch How It's Made?
And so somebody has actually made a Pie High Dog Twitter account.
Oh my God, dog? By the way, is hilarious. The Pie High Dog actually had me spit out my coffee when he tweeted just randomly in the middle of the day, high as numbers, y'all.
It looks to be true. Is that a real dog?
That's a real dog who's having a real birthday party, who's really being served cake.
That is really, really high.
That's right. It's clearly the Pie High Dog. There's no doubt about it.
I think that dog is looking at the camera saying, help me.
Okay, look, I don't want to take too much of it. How are you digging Portal 2?
I just started getting into it. I was going to play it, and I started watching your show. Your show finished. I started going back to playing it, and then you called me.
That's our motto on NSFW Show. We want to be the show that you
annoy
always...
Tom Merritt as much as possible at any turn.
Hey, how far are you into Portal 2?
I'm not very far at all. I just made through the tutorial of how to walk around.
And J.K. Simmons is doing like a lot of the narration in that?
Is that who it is? Is it J.K. Simmons?
It's the guy that's talking, right?
That's
Schwood.
What, Schwood?
Yeah, you did the narration from Portal 2. I'm
no,
making
not
a
me. Okay, no, no, no.
I'm making
no,
a stupid joke. No, it is J.K. Simmons.
Yeah, you know, no.
I think.
Well, who's the? I'm sure they'll tell me right here in the thing. What?
I think.
What's his
I'm
name?
I'm not sure.
Oh, Juno's dad. Are you realizing who J.K. Simmons is?
Wheatley is Simmons. Okay, Stephen Merchant is Wheatley, right? Stephen Merchant. J.K. is later. He does. Yeah, no,
oh,
he plays
later.
Like three
okay,
characters
I haven't
got
that
in there.
Yet.
Yeah.
Okay.
Stephen Merchant is the British guy who does the Wheatley robot. It's so good. I finished it last night.
You finished Portal 2?
Yeah, no, it was amazing.
Wow.
It was awesome.
There's J.K. Simmons.
Oh, shoot. Yeah, that is J.K. Simmons. That's right.
No, well, that's actually just a doll of J.K. Simmons.
No, no, Tom. It's actually a doll, character of J.K. No, actually, and what he means is that this doll did the narration for Portal 2. The actor has no
pointing action.
Yes. Okay, so no spoilers on Portal 2. I played through the whole thing and live streamed the entire playing through of it.
Oh, you did it on live stream?
Yeah, and I actually have scheduled tonight, I'm going to play through the co-op with my old college roommate. And in fact, if you want to hang out, and actually, I'd love to get your commentary as we play through Portal 2.
Why not?
All right, that'll be fun. That'll be fun. So sticking around there, I do have to encode this episode. Thank you again, Tom. So I guess just I'm assuming it's a foregone conclusion that tomorrow's Tech News Today will be one where you start off with random nonsense and then always end up talking technology.
Yeah, it'll be our normal show, exactly.
Yeah.
NSFWTN.
There we go. All right. Well, look, thank you so much, man. And we'll wrap things up here for reals. That's the after show wrapped up. And then that way, Tony can edit this business.